season. So, some big games with some big playoff implications this week. And then we'll be on to the playoffs, where I'll be doing my predictions for that next week as well. I'm not sure if you are able to tell that much of a difference, but I am without my normal microphone for this video, so I do apologize for that if the sound quality is a little bit lower. My girlfriend accidentally took my computer charger home with her after staying with me for last weekend, and I use my microphone with OBS on my computer to record the audio, and then I put it together with the video recording from my phone, but my computer is dead now, so I don't have the option for that, so I'm just using my AirPods on my phone because I wanted to get this video out to you guys, so I hope that it sounds okay. And with that being said, we'll get into our predictions for this week. As usual, start with our Thursday night game. This week, that game is the Chiefs versus the Raiders. The Chiefs are 13-3, and the Raiders are 6-10. Kansas City's favored 9.5, and the over-under is 52.5. I'm going to take the Chiefs to win this game. We'll go 31-24. Jarrett Stidham had a good start last week versus the 49ers, but I don't think he's enough to get it done versus the high-powered Chiefs offense in this one. Moving on to Saturday. Actually, I don't think Chiefs Raiders is Thursday night. I think that's Saturday. I don't think there is a Thursday night game this week. I think that is a Saturday game. And this is the Saturday night game, Titans-Jaguars. I usually have my computer out for seeing when the games are and such, but obviously, like I said, I don't have that today, so apologies if I messed up the day that game's being played. The Titans are 7-9, and the Jaguars are 8-8. The over-under is 40, and the Jaguars are favored 6. This is a huge game because the winner makes the playoffs as the winner of the AFC South. The Titans are starting quarterback Josh Dobbs this weekend over rookie Malik Willis, with Ryan Tannehill being injured. The Jaguars are playing some really good football, and they're basically two teams trending in opposite directions, so I'm going to take the Jaguars here. Take the Jaguars 27-17 and have them win the division and all but knock the Titans out of the playoffs. Moving on to Sunday, we have Patriots-Bills. Patriots are 8-8 and the Bills are 12-3. The over-under is 42.5 and the Bills are favored 7.5 points. The Bills obviously coming off that postponed game with DeMar Hamlin's very serious injury. It seems like he's doing better hour by hour now, which is really good to hear. He's still not fully recovered. I think he still might be in pretty serious condition, but things are looking up for him, which is good. But I'm sure the Bills are going to be highly motivated to win this one for him. The crowd is going to have a lot of emotion, a lot of energy. And, I mean, the Bills are just a better team than the Patriots, so I'm going to take them to win here. Go 28-13 for the Bills. As much as it pains me to say, as a Patriots fan, if the Patriots win this game, they are in the playoffs. But if they lose, they still have a chance to make it if the Dolphins, Steelers, and one other team lose. I can't remember who exactly right now, but they need... Oh, and the Titans. So if the Titans, Dolphins, and Steelers all lose, the Patriots are still in. So hoping for that, but not counting on it. Next up is Bucks versus Falcons. The Bucks are 8-8, and the Falcons are 6-10. The Falcons are favored by 4, and the over-under is 40. Based on the line, it seems to me like the Bucks will be resting some of their starters, if not the majority of them, since they clinched a playoff spot last weekend with a win over the Panthers. So I'm going to take the Falcons here, since the Bucks aren't really playing for much. I guess the Falcons aren't either, since they're eliminated, but I'm still going to take them here. I'll go 21-17 for the Falcons. Next is Vikings-Bears. The Vikings are 12-4, and the Bears are 3-13. The Vikings are favored 7.5, and the over-under is 43. I'll take the Vikings here, but I think the Bears might make it a little close. I said in my recap video yesterday that the Vikings are my new biggest fraud team in the NFL, surpassing the Giants. So I do think they win this game, but I'll go 24-20 over the Bears. Ravens versus Bengals. The Ravens are 10-6, and the Bengals are 11-4. The Bengals are favored 7, and the over-under is 42. Again, I'm going to take the favorite here. I'll take Cincinnati to win. I don't think Lamar Jackson is playing in this one. I think they're resting him for the playoffs. And even with him, I think Cincinnati's the better team. I'll go 30-20 for Cincinnati. Quite a few big spreads in these first few games. I know I'm picking all favorites right now, but hopefully we can change that here. Maybe get some upset picks. We have Texans versus Colts next. The Texans are 2-13-1, and the Colts are 4-11-1. The over-under is 38, and the Colts are favored 2.5. And I think this is our first underdog pick of the week. I will ride with the Texans here, and I'll go 24-20 over the Colts. Honestly, it might end up being like 17-13 for one of the teams, but we'll go with this. They're both pretty bad teams, and I could easily see the Texans winning on the road here. Neither team has much to play for. The Texans, honestly, let's see here. I think they actually do have the number one pick locked up at this point, so I guess it doesn't even matter if they win in that scenario either. So yeah, actually, the Bears could get the number one pick, I believe, if they win and the Texans, or sorry, if they lose and the Texans win. So it might not be in the Texans' best interest to win this week. And next we have Jets versus Dolphins. The Jets are 7-9, and the Dolphins are 8-8. The Jets are favored 1, and the over-under is 38.5. Based on the spread, it doesn't seem like Tua Tagovailoa will be playing again this week. And honestly, Teddy Bridgewater might be out as well. I know he got injured during the Patriots game last week during a pick six by Kyle Duggar. So Skylar Thompson might be in at quarterback for the Dolphins. I'm going to take them to win, though, at home. The Jets haven't looked very good the last few games. Mike White has been struggling a bit. I'll go 20-17 for the Dolphins. Next is Panthers at Saints. The Panthers are 6-10, and the Saints are 7-9. The Saints are favored 3.5, and the over-under is 41.5. Two more teams eliminated from playoff contention here. I'll take the Panthers to win this one. They've been playing pretty well recently. I'll go 24-14 for Carolina. I think the Saints beating the Eagles, I don't know. I think the line might be a little inflated because of that game, but next is the Browns versus the Steelers. The Browns are 7-9, and the Steelers are 8-8. The Steelers are favored 2.5, and the over-under is 40. I'll take the Steelers here. They've been winning a lot of good, close, tough football games recently on a nice little playoff push they have going. And I'll take them 17-13 in another gritty win over the Browns. Chargers Broncos is next. The Chargers are 10-6, and the Broncos are 4-12. The over-under is 40, and the Broncos are favored 2. Going to take the Broncos to win here. I believe the Chargers are resting all of their starters. for the playoffs since they have already clinched. So I will take the Broncos at home here, and I'll go 17-10 for Denver. Giants-Eagles is next. The Giants are 9-6-1, and the Eagles are 13-3. The over-under is 43, and the Eagles are favored 14 points. I will be taking the Eagles to win here. I'm not sure if Jalen Hurts is back this week or not, but the Giants have nothing to gain or lose from this game. And the Eagles need to win to clinch the one seed, which I'm sure they really want to do. So I'll take the Eagles here. I'll go 31-20. Next is Cardinals 49ers. The Cardinals are 4-12, and the 49ers are 12-4. The over-under is 40.5, and the 49ers are favored 14.5. Cardinals obviously long gone, long eliminated, and the 49ers can still acquire the one seed in the NFC, so they'll be playing hard in this one, and I think they win pretty handedly. We'll go 34-17 for the 49ers. Then we have the Rams versus Seahawks. The Rams are 5-11, and the Seahawks are 8-8. The over-under is 41.5, and the Seahawks are favored 6.5. We'll go with the Seahawks here. 24-17. They need to win to have a chance to get into the playoffs, so I think the Seahawks will give it all they have out there. And then we have the Cowboys versus the Commanders. The Cowboys are 12-4, and the Commanders are 7-8-1. The Cowboys are favored 7.5, and the over-under is 41. The Commanders are starting rookie Sam Howell at quarterback this week. Taylor Heinicke was in line to get the start, but then apparently told coaches that he thought the rookie deserved the shot to start this final game of the season for them. Which, honestly, big respect to Taylor Heinicke for that, for giving Howell a shot. He does have to face a tough Cowboys defense, though, so I'm not sure how nice of a gesture that really was. But, yeah, the rookie will be starting this game versus the Cowboys, and I will take the Cowboys to win here. We'll go 27-13 for the Cowboys. Projecting a bit of a rough start for Howell, but who knows, he could surprise a lot of people. I'm sure he'll be hungry out there to spoil this win for the Cowboys and win his first career start, so. And finally, we have the Sunday night game. There is no Monday night game this week. The final game of the regular season will be Lions-Packers. Both teams 8-8. The over-under is set at 49, and the Packers are favored 4.5. I think, a win, and the Packers are in the playoffs, so a pretty huge game for them at Lambeau versus their division rival. This should be a very exciting, very fun game to watch with a lot of drama, hopefully. And I ultimately will take the Packers to win here. We'll go 31-28 on a last-second field goal, because why not? Sounds like a fun game to end the regular season on. And that will do it for my Week 18 NFL predictions. Let me know in the comments what you think I got right, what you think I have wrong, and what your biggest upset pick of the week is. I don't think I have too many big ones. There's a lot of pretty big spreads. I'm sure one of these teams will be upset this week, but I just can't pick out who at the moment. But let me know if you have any ideas yourself. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope the audio quality was fine for you guys compared to normal without the mic. And I hope you have a great rest of your day. And I will see you next time.